Hi everybody, this is Dylan Kramer, and I wanted to take a minute here and talk a little bit about quadrant solving and the solutions that we help you integrate into your business. What I'm here doing is talking a little bit about my email, and what I wanted to do is show you how I manage my email to more effectively embody and encompass the quadrants. What you'll see here is a couple of different things. The first one is my email is sorted by quadrants and project. So, for example, my mortgage company, America's Mortgage Choice, has some operations issues, Q1 marketing, where we talk a little bit about things we do on Craigslist, data that we're exchanging, Facebook and Twitter, blog content, the networking group that I belong to, LaTip, realtors, specific Twitter stuff as well. Additionally, once we get done marketing, we find customers and we get into sales. So we'll talk a little bit about leads and the people that we're talking to, exchanging emails with, or possibly even getting communication from the realtors. For example, here are all the names of people that we're in some stage of the lead process with and hoping to gain their mortgage business. Here, as a matter of fact, is a great one to take a look at as we convert to Q3. This is the realtor. Here's a contact and listing sheet, and as a matter of fact, I am going to zoom in on that and bring this over here. Attached is the contract and agreed upon terms of the listing sheet. Just sent it over for three changes, but here are the specifics. So I've already forwarded this to my assistant, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it and I'm going to bring it over here, and the screen will come with, and we'll drop it in the Davis lead file. But here's the really neat thing that we're going to do. We're going to move down and we're going to open Q3, customer service or processing in the mortgage practice as well, and go specifically to the loans. And as you can see, we also have a bunch of loans in process. So we're going to take them from Q2, where they were a lead, and move this folder that we've created into Q3 loans. And now we're able to manage them as part of the pipeline. So we're able to move from Q2 to Q3 in order to make that happen. It helps us become more effective in the way we manage our business to talk to people based on quadrants, all the loans we have in process on the mortgage end, and then everything that we've got for our annuity solution. When the loans are closed, we move them in closed 2008, 2009, and we always have a record of the communication that we've had with clients on an ongoing basis. This has been a Quadrant Solving Minute. If you have any questions, we welcome your input at info@quadrantsolving.com to learn more about how we can coach, train, and develop you to become a quadrant solving expert and affect these changes in your business practice. Go to quadrantsolving.com.